A lack of this has led to this. Painfully low snowpack statewide, but that's about to change.
This cold front bringing a big change. How cold and how much snow?
Chief Meteorologist Mike Nelson is tracking this First Alert Action Day hour by hour.
Denver 7 starts right now.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Shannon Ogden.
And I'm Ann Trujillo, and let's get right to the live radar as the system pushes into our state. You can see the snow on the way, and tomorrow you will feel the cold with a 40-degree drop in 24 hours.
And Mike, the system's changed in the past 24 hours.
It has. It's coming from central Canada, so it's going to be cold, but not super moist. But a big change will be in temperatures. 66, almost a record today. Tomorrow, it'll be in the mid-20s. With temperatures getting even colder by tomorrow night, thanks to this front that's just now pushing closer to the Denver area. It's just about into the Fort Collins area now. We do not have any winter weather advisories right along the I-25 corridor, but most of the mountains under a winter weather advisory for up to 8 inches of snow between now and about 6 o'clock tomorrow evening. So here are the highlights on this storm. Much colder tomorrow. Not a huge snowmaker for the I-25 corridor, the Denver area, but with those colder temperatures, slick ramps and bridges will be likely starting tomorrow morning. In the metro area, about 22 for the morning commute with some slick bridges and ramps. Foothills, temperatures also low 20s, but a little bit more snow, so the roads there should be slushy and slick. How much to expect in your neighborhood? I'll have the answer for you in just a few minutes.
And we just got our first school closing for tomorrow. St. Mary's Academy in Cherry Hills Village. And you can always find delays and closing on our website, thedenverchannel.com. And CDOT put out an alert this evening warning that this storm will impact travel statewide. The department says crews are out in full force pre-treating the roads right now. They're going to work around the clock until the snow stops.
And by all indications, this storm should not impact travel out of DIA. You can expect planes to go through de-icing as the temps dip below freezing, but airlines already build that time into their schedules. And DIA just sent us updated holiday travel stats. Nearly 2.5 million passengers will move through DIA between now and New Year's Day. This Friday is expected to be the busiest day with nearly 190,000 travelers, but that's not even close to the biggest travel day in the airport's history, so Friday will likely come in at around 53rd.